Channel 5 all people, you're back with me, Hot Chuck, and today I have a super strong, tanky budget deck for you that can take wins off a lot of top decks in this format. Let's get involved. So today I'm bringing you a Metagross VMAX deck. Metagross VMAX is a VMAX Pokemon. Rapid Strike as well, 330 HP, that is a tanky geezer with two attacks. First one is Zap Traction. Search your deck for two cards and put them into your hand. Honestly, not a bad little attack if you miss, if you have a missed an attack for whatever reason, you can use Zap Traction to help yourself get set up. Also could be good in some late game scenarios, helping you find bosses or orders or something like this, you know what I mean? And then our main attack though is Max Rush for one metal, one colorless. You do 100 damage, and then during your next turn, this attack does an extra 150. So, the first attack is 100 damage. That's not very good, not gonna lie to you. However, 2 for 250 is extremely good. Let's not beat around the bush. Put a choice band on there, you're doing 280 damage, which is a good number because that one-shots every V-Star. One-shot every V-Star for 2 energy. Pretty scary, huh? So, not only can we hit like a truck, but if we utilize the really good setup stage 1 Pokemon that is Bronzong, 110 HP with that metal transfer ability, allowing you to move metal energy around your board. So the idea is we're going to have a Metagross VMAX doing 250 damage every turn, and we can move the energies around. Now, not only if we move the energies around, can we use other attackers such as Zacian V, which free energy does 230 damage. You never know, that's going to come in handy, and has that really good Intrepid Sword ability, letting you draw 3 cards and then turn. But if we can move around energy, that means we can utilize Cheryl, a really good supporter card, which lets you heal all damage from your evolution Pokemon, but you have to discard the energy. Now, normally that is balanced by the fact you have to discard the energy, right? However, with Bronzong, you just move the energies off, Cheryl, move them back on for a little bit of cheekiness, baby. We also get to utilize Bibarel, a stage 1 Pokemon with that industrious incisors, let you draw till you have 5 cards in your hand, letting us hopefully use supporters like Bosses, Orders and Cheryl that don't normally let us draw cards. We can get the draws with the barrel. So here's the list. We've got a 3-3 line of the Bronze on. We've got 1 Crobat, so we can draw up to 6 cards in our hand, again helping us find those Cheryls and Bosses, Orders as and when we need them. 4-3 on the Metagross. Here's a little cheeky tip for you. Rainbow Rares are normally cheaper on TCGO than normal. We also got 1 Lumineon, that Luminous Sign ability, which will let you, when you bench it, grab a supporter from the deck. Like I said, I've mentioned Cheryl is very important. Lumineon V will get us Cheryl. Now, if you're on a super type budget, this deck's already quite cheap. You can get this like under 20 packs, I think. If you're on a super type budget, though, feel free to get rid of Lumineon, Zacian, and Crobat. They're not really essential. Feel free to beef out these lines here, get some more Bidoof from the barrels, and you should be okay. You could even go down a Cramomatic route if you wanted. There's some favorite. 2 Evolution Incense, so we can grab ourselves Bronzongs and the barrels and the VMAX. Only 3 Metal Sources. Now, that might seem odd because obviously getting energy in play is really good. However, when your main attacker is only attacking for 2 energy, you don't really need to have that many energies in play for Metagross VMAX. That's why you only play 3, and you could cut that as well. 4 Quick Ball, because that searches for our basically searches for everything outside the barrel, Bronzong, and Metagross VMAX. 2 Switch, just in case we need to like reset with Brave Blade or we've led a Pokemon we don't want to. 4 Ultra Ball, that searches everything in the deck and gets metal energies in the discard pile for metal sources. Our stage of choice is Path to the Peak. Now, you got to be careful with this one because it turns off all wall box abilities. So that means you are actively stopping Crobat from working, Lumineon from working, and Zacian from working. However, I do think it is worth it. If you didn't want to use Path to the Peak, you could use something like Crystal Cave instead, which is fine, which just lets you heal 30 damage from each of your metal Pokemon. Seems quite good to me. However, I think locking off opponent's wall box abilities is more important. 2 Bosses Order, so we can hit what we want when we want, because what our opponent's going to do is maybe when we start hitting for the 280, they might try and retreat in around, so we're only taking 1 prize, a card at a time. Bosses Orders gets around that. 2 of the Cheryls, like I mentioned earlier, you could play a 3rd if you wanted. 3 Marnie for a little bit of draw and hand disruption for our opponent, which you will see. Professor's Research, discard in our hand and draw 7 is crazy. Best supporter in the game. Always play 4 if you can. two choice belts. So we're going to get from that 250 to that 280 range. That is a big number. Like I said, Oko's every V-Star in format. And then 10 Metal Energy as well. Sound good? Let's get to the gameplay, baby. Cheers. Right then, here we go with some Metagross VMAX. Pretty fun card, in all honesty. You know, doing 280 damage for 2 energy is nothing to sniff at once you get rolling. So let's see how we go. We are going second. We have led ourselves a bit doof, which isn't the greatest. But, you know, all in all, that's a good. No supporter. Maybe this hand isn't great. What does this do? So, this is actually pretty good against our deck, not gonna lie. So, okay, now I'm trying to think. What do we do here? Do we, like, assume that we're not gonna get KO'd? I mean, yeah, actually, that is one. So, yeah, I'm just gonna assume that we're not gonna get KO'd. Actually, we could switch now. Yeah, I think switching now is probably safer. If they have the DT, then they have it, right? They could also Melanie, though. But we do get a cheeky little bullet punch! A cheeky little 40. There's where it's weak to metal, is it? Now, they could Melanie get to this Ancient Freeze. I should say, this is the problem. If your defending Pokemon is a V or GX, it can't attack during your opponent's next turn. So that's problematic. However, if they was to use that now, he can just evolve. That clears the effect, then we can max rush. An ideal turn for us would be evolve, attach, barrel. Okay, nice. We also get a Zacian down, which is nice. So we can do something like this. Another way around it is to also just switch. So if we can develop ourselves like a Bronzong, Bronzor, we can just switch between attackers. That also works in this scenario. I think we actually want to hold this hand. So what we're going to do is just put down Bronzor. Next turn, grab ourselves Crobat. So we'll just max rush. So the idea is now what we can do, hopefully, is get some cards and then finish this Arctifish V off with a Zacian. That's the idea. Now, because we cannot attack this turn. How much health have you got? 80. Could even risk attacking with barrel if you wanted. Right, so what does Zap Traction do? Search your deck for. How much is it? Okay. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Let's see if we can draw into a switch, we've effectively won, alright? For his belt. Do we have any? No, we've got shells. Do we have any cards that can switch off a supporter from Lumineon? But I don't think we do, actually. It's a bit sad. Let's have a check. Yeah, there's Lumineon. I don't think. Yeah, we've got one switch left in deck. We could boss. Oh, no, we can't attack, so we. No. I guess. Here we just go for Crobat. See if we can draw the switch. I still think we're in a very fine position, let's be honest. Double Saucer is interesting. 90%. If only we had some more in the discard pile. this hand is decent, though. I guess what we could do, actually, is just move the energy off. Move one energy off down here. Done. Oh, no, we can't Zap Traction because we can't even attack. Oh, yo, that's very good, that is. I guess we can just drop it then, actually. Yeah, it's just Intrepid. Okay, we do get the switch for next turn. Okay. So we were only 2 cards off. Maybe we should have researched there, huh? Now, that's one thing we've got to worry about. This thing is a fire type, so it will hit us for weakness. Oh my goodness, they have copycatted our big fat hand. We are getting played, ladies and gentlemen. We are just pawns in this family's world. Oh my lord, is they've got all this stuff going on as well. Okay, this is actually getting a bit scary. Like, let's not beat around the bush. Now, we do have access to our boss, right? We do, so... We've got a bit of a problem in the sense that once we KO this, I'm assuming this just responds, right? 20, so it'd do what? 4, 8, 12... Oh, it doesn't actually. Okay, cool. So what we've got to do then is metal transfer. Get this. Move that down here. Done. Switch into this. Anything else we can do? This there's a lot of good cards in this hand, but we might have to research this away, you know. I guess we could get Marnie actually. Yeah, let's do that. I like all these cards. We are filling a bench, but I'm hoping to not let the Kyogres go to work. That's my thinking. They will Marnie. Give them less cards. Gives us less cards, though, but we're not guaranteed to join to any of them, which is nice, right? We do get energy, and we get the boss. Nice. Boss is really good there, actually. Now we can attach energy here. Industrious Incisors. Draw some cards. Back to the peak. Yeah, let's put that into play. Now we'll Brave Blade. We get energy out of the prizes. And a Cheryl. Cheryl's actually pretty nice, actually. Honestly. So I think we just boss a Kyogre, right? Is that correct? Don't suppose they're weak to metal, are they? No. They only got two. Interesting. We'll move that there. Done. Now, do you want to show this turn or do you want a boss, actually? The Shameless got 130. But we can't KO it. maybe we boss up this one, actually. I think that actually makes the most sense. Yeah, we'll boss up that one. So we'll pay retreat, attach, metal transfer, up here, done. Do we want a saucer? We want to spread out our energy, right? I think we'll saucer there, then metal transfer it off. Done. Now, surely they haven't got a switching card, right? Surely not. Not on a three card hand. They didn't play anything last time. It's all max rush. The idea is now this Metagross is going to try and see us the way. If we don't get Kyogre this turn, we can shovel. I think we'll be okay. Although, we do have to be careful of this Donnie, actually. 4, 8, 12, 6. Okay, so we're not getting no code by this yet. So we got a big turn here. This is a scary turn. We can shovel. No energy goes in the bin. They've attached there. Wow. Okay, nice. Okay, so now we can metal transfer then. Move these down here. Move this down here. Done. Cheryl. Metal transfer. Move them back up here. Or at least two. And we want to spread them out, I reckon. Actually. Tell you what, yeah, let's put him on the Zay Shino. Actually, no. We'll leave him on Bibarel. See if we can attract them to KO that. I apologize for taking my time. Done. Then we will attach here. Then we will Industrious Incisors. I would have really liked to draw into the boss there, to be honest with you. Now we max rush anyway. Go down to three. Now the scary thing is, right? They're gonna take a ton of prizes here, I assume. Then the Volcaron is gonna come in. That's the problem. Mainly, oh, they're gonna, ooh, they're gonna fire blast us. That's not okay with that, actually. Maybe they miss. They got three. They only got three. That's actually really important. That means they can't KO bare stuff. Oh my goodness. So now they go down to four. Okay, it's actually fine. We're doing okay. I promise you. Okay, so now what we do is try and set up another Metagross VMAX open. Do we boss this actually? No, I think what we gotta do is KO this. What, go down to two? Ooh, it's actually a bit tricky. We have to KO this, because this could win the game next turn, right? This is gonna KO this, so we need to set up another attacker, yeah. I need to find energy, funnily enough. Well, it's a bit interesting how we haven't got any more energy, in which case we might have to Marnie them. Yeah, let's Marnie. We still got Metal Sources as well, actually. Yeah, that was actually perfect. perfect Marnie there for sure, right? I think what we'll do now is source of these. This deck won't play Marnie, so we kind of want to draw back into our boss if possible. So I'm just going to shuffle the deck. Oh, actually, oh, we should have put them on Zacian. Oh, that's a misplay. Ah, oh, yeah, we could have missed. I think we might have misplayed there for sure. Yeah, no, we might have thrown the game, everybody. Yeah, so now we have to max rush. Yeah. Oh, we misplayed so bad because Zacian just Oko's the Volcarona. Oh, how many sources have we seen? Oh, wait a minute. They went into Kroganal. We might be okay. Sonya. Okay, no, we're not. It's got a one retreat cast. Oh, they're playing with my emotions. Abominable. Unexpected that. Yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah. So I think we've lost. How much does it have to discard? Just the one? Just the one. So you get rid of the water. Yeah, okay. Oh, that's not a KO! Oh! Yeah! How bad am I? I just completely forgot that Fire Blast actually isn't a KO. Metagross is hard body, baby. What they should have done is go for the first attack there, but shh, we won't tell them about that. Let's keep it moving. Which one do we start here? This has got to be bronze, all right? It's got a one retreat cost. It's not a very good hand, though. And we're going second as well. Oh, dearie me. Hopefully we can get a quick ball or something. We're playing against Whimsicott. That's weak to metal, actually. So we could be in for a fun time. All we got to do is set up. I have a theory here that one Metagross VMAX can easily carry us this game. All we got to do is set up. Okay. We get two mullies as well. Ultra Ball Marnie. This could be a fun one. This could be a fun one. Okay. Obviously, we've got Hammer Flips to worry about as well. But You know, we've got Metal Sorcerer actually to get around that. So I think what we're going to do, Ultra Ball away. Are they playing like Mewtwo V Union? That's a Mewtwo V Union card I've ever seen it, right? They got rid of a Crushing Hammer and a Final Waves. Nice. Looks like our opponent's dead drawing a little bit. We get a Bidoof off the top as well. Okay. You have to get rid of what? Evo Energy. We're not going to play the Marnie this time. That's for sure. Do we actually start setting up a Metagross actually? That's probably better. We'll just Intrepid. Oh, we get one off the top actually. Nice. And one good thing is they actually missed energy. So that means this Bronzor's okay. There's a world actually in where we can evolve, get this out the active, and get swing with the VMAX next turn. Because our opponent missed energy. And that's one thing about the Whimsicott deck, that missing energy is gross. Oh, you get a head stir. But we do play Metal Sword. Hopefully you can draw into that. What does this do? If this Pokemon puts out to have the same amount of energy attached. What damage does that do? 50. Rested. But it's our opponent. Oh no, I was going to say our opponent's in Dead Jaw City, but they do have their young Bibarel to get them out of this. Now, I think, realistically, we should be prioritizing Zacian, right? Because Zacian just cocos, and we can move the energy off. Yeah, so let's go. Let's start getting back in with the Zacian. We could get Fluff Ball starred here, actually. They're going to Fluff Ball star active. Good thing they then got two tails, though. That's not. Do they Fluff Ball start active? I'm trying to think. I might do that, you know. Yeah, they do. Okay. Two retreat costs. Right. So. I think we'll just do something like this. Do we want to fill our bench? I think we don't mind, actually. Let's Industrious Incisors. We want to see a lot of cards here. Let's see if we can get the KO. Good start. Double Saucer. Don't worry about them hammers, my friend, yeah? Oh, yeah, this board setup's fine, right? Gross. Don't even need to play a supporter. Get out! don't get out of my way with this inconvenienceness. Oh dear. Yeah! Turn two fresher, baby. Love to see it. Let's keep it moving. Oh, this hand is like so close to being awesome. I guess we got a top deck actually. Lucario V-Star. Okay. Do we have to bench this? This could be a Crobat hand, actually. Maybe we... Oh, all these cards are so good, though. Maybe I have to get rid of Research. Research Bronzong? Oh, I really don't know. All these cards are so good. No, hold on. We're probably going to have to play the Research, right? So that means we can get rid of the Cheryl. For a Metagross. This got one energy attack. Card energy. Is weak to fighting. Maybe we switch into this. Okay. It shouldn't be too hard for us to find, hopefully, some way to get our Metagross V rocking next turn, right? I doubt they commit a double colorless now. Maybe they do. Rope Tool Scrapper. Interesting. They go for this. 70 for each energy attached to your opponent's Pokemon. Well, we can play around that. We can play around that. And they pass. Nice! Okay. There goes both our shells. Okay. Bit sad. Oh, so we've almost got an attack here, but not actually. We've almost got it, though. So we probably... What do we need to find? Oh, no, we have got everything we need for an attack. What am I on about? Because we can attach Metal Saucer. Okay, so I'm chatting with it. Maybe we just grab a Zacian. Yeah, there's me being silly. Okay. Done. Oh, we definitely shouldn't have Vulture Pulled for Zacian. It should have been for Crowbar or something. That's okay, though. I'm not even going to put it down, actually. Still max wash. This is quite good because I put it in Mist Energy. So that means we're not going to get hit with a Lucario this turn. So once we get that 250, all we've got to do realistically is try and find ourselves Choice Band. And we are off to the races. We actually one-shot these Lucarios, right? If we find Choice Band. The problem is we are dead drawing right now. Do we one-shot these? Yes! Very sad we had to get rid of both our shells. They would have been so clutch in this matchup. Our opponent has double the barrel. Wow. Right for summon up. We could probably be okay just by doing 250 a turn. Now, if we top deck Choice Band now. If we top deck any ball search. We top deck anything good, please. Yes, you have to. You don't evolve this one. Gotta hold on to that one, good sir. Yep, okay. Something good. Metal Saucer. No. 250. Yeah, so close. I guess actually, do we hit this one? This one's damaged. I mean, they can't V-star it. I think we do. Bah! Take two prize cards. So if we take something good out of the prize cards here. Ooh, baby! Oh, there's a choice! Oh, no Marnie, please. No Marnie to... Oh, no! A stone fighting! I was so excited. And now my excitement's gone. Oh, no. Is it a two-shot? 240? That's not a two-shot, actually. Hey, what am I on about two? But why is damage decreased? Can I resist fighting? Did it say damage? Oh, because of the double turbo. Okay, so what we can do now is start setting up a Zacian, I guess. After the peak, probably want to leave that out, actually. God, that stone fighting. Does that actually, hold on. Do we do 280? Yeah, we're 10 off. Okay. So excited. Ah, okay. I guess we'll, what's that, 250? Does that ever matter there? No, I guess we'll put it there. As if they had stone fighting. You know how sad that is? Is there ever an argument to attack with the Zacian here? I don't think so, actually, right? No. We just want to try and get energy down here, right? So in order to do that, we need to see some cards. So let's get rid of Marnie. Do you have a VMAX left? Oh, we do, okay. We gotta find Crobat here. Actually, let's Ultra Ball these two away for a barrel. So what I'm trying to do now is just get another Metagross set up, right? Little bench. Industrious Incisors. If we had Cheryl now, we'd be laughing. Quick roll away, Bidoof. Spell search. Crobat. Oh, come on, man. We missed. Very silly. We missed all our energy and thing. Still max wash anyway. As if they had that stone fighting. I still think we're in a good spot though, because what we can do next turn, start attacking with this one. This one actually KOs that, and then just KOs that, and we're done, right? Make sure our energy count isn't too crazy, so we don't play into the Lucario V-Stars ability. What is this? What is this? Then you discard specials, right? Yeah, we one-shot that. First chill. So, was our opponent going to try and attack with this? Not a bad play, actually, if they do. No, they don't. Okay, so they take three prizes. I think we're still in a good spot. We do really have to get attacked with this Metagross now, though. we have to find another VMAX, essentially, right? So we're going to this. So we can Metagross VMAX. Dorsa, don't leave any extra energy in play for obvious reasons. So we don't play into the Aura Star. 70 for each energy attached. And I think we definitely Marnie. So we move this, move this. And I think this might be a checkmate scenario. I don't know what our opponent can promote that takes a hit from the Max Rush. So I think we should be okay, hopefully. No need to do anything else, right? Yes! And our opponent knows it. We just checkmated them, baby. Let me know what you think of Metagross VMAX. I think it's really fun and it's a really good budget deck as well. Real has good potential and good fundamentals, which is what you want from a budget deck. If you're gonna buy any of these cards from Channel 5, make sure you use my code HOTCHOCK. Helps me out and helps you out as well. Hit the like button. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.